Rise and fright, you ghasts and ghouls. My name is hold on, guys. I forgot my Halloween costume. Oh, hello. To Freddy Fazbear? That's right, gamers. It's me, Freddy FNAF Bear. Subscribe to Tetsume YouTube channel. You might say this is the Bite of 87 moment, guys. You might say, like, can we get this video to 800 and... Can we get this video to 1873 like... What was the number? I forgot. Okay. I'm done with that. No more dilly-dallying. We actually have a lot of stuff to do today. And before we actually get into anything, I do want to say, I know it's not Halloween. I know I'm like probably a week and a few days off of Halloween. But listen, it's still fall or autumn, whatever you want to call it. I'm still in my spooky feels. So as you guys can see here, I got myself a little Halloween themed inventory UI on it. I got myself some Halloween themed resource packs on, so everything looks nice and festive and fall. All the trees change colors and stuff. It looks awesome. I think some of the mobs, yeah, look, there's like a creeper over there, and it's like, I don't know, maybe the leaves or something. I don't know, but everything has like costumes on. This chicken here is like a, I don't know, like a vampire devil chicken. It's so cool. But listen, like I was saying, we have a lot of stuff that I want to do this episode. So let's go ahead and get straight into it. And the first thing I want to actually do is go ahead and come into here, make ourselves a bunch of this sugar, make ourselves, I guess not make ourselves a bunch of pumpkin, we just have the pumpkins, but I want to make a ton of this pumpkin pie because it is a nice festive thing to eat. And I think it's probably better than carrots for eating. I'm pretty sure, at least honestly, I could be completely wrong about that. And then before I actually get into explaining what our real plans are for this episode, I want to first make ourselves a diamond pickaxe because we are going to go down here into my little farming area over here, which also, by the way, can I just say, I made look very nice and pretty. I got this kind of walkway down here. I got some sugar cane. I got some wheat. And look at that. Even you can kind of see it from here. But I made myself a little scarecrow. I somewhat learned how to do item stand stuff, so I gave him some arms and a sword. So like, look at that, I got a nice scarecrow looking out from my pumpkins and seeds and all that. But oh god, that's annoying. But we're going over here to this lava that I've accidentally turned into obsidian, and we are gonna mine some of it up because what we have to do is we need to go into the nether and grab a very specific block. I didn't really plan ahead to where we'll build the portal, but I guess like right here is would look fine. Oh god. Ooh, and there we go. We are now in the nether. And I thought that was like the ceiling of the nether, but it is just it's just the biome. We're in the basalt columns or something. The basalt deltas. Yeah, okay. You know, I won't even lie, we got a pretty cool spawn. It is super dangerous, but we're on like a floating island of bath salt. Like, that's kinda awesome. I just said bath salt instead of basalt. This is not the block we need, but I also do want some quartz. Oh, here it is. This is what we need. Oh, let's go. Easy achievement. Oh, never mind. I'm bad. Easy. There we go. Easy achievement. Yeah, I think this is probably enough soul sand. Oh, and yeah, I didn't even mention this in the intro, but like, look at this. We got a nice staircase going up to our house now. I don't need to climb up this mountain every time I go up to, I guess it's not a mountain, it's a hill. But I don't need to climb up this hill every time I need to go up to my house because I actually built this off camera. It's really basic. You guys can take a look at it. It's pretty much just my normal block palette slash style of building where I use this like deep slate, I think it's called. And then all these spruce woods and stuff like that. And it's just really easy to now go to my house. But moving on, gamers, I can finally show you guys what we are actually going to be doing for the majority of this episode. And it is just here past these trees where I used to have, you know, my big tree farm. And it is actually right over here. You guys can sort of see the beginning of something. You can see that I planted a bunch of these big trees. And I'll get into why I did that in a minute. But I also have some foundations laid out. You can see I have some weird blocks kind of going around this area in like a large perimeter, and I'll show you that perimeter a little bit later, or you guys can see it in the replay mod. And then over here you can see we got a whole chest full of a bunch of wood and then also some like miscellaneous building materials. And what I'm planning on doing for this area right here, I'll show you guys right now in my creative world as I'm loading in. I hope it all looks the same because I haven't actually looked at the build with this resource pack on. But if I go ahead and fly up here, you guys can see some of these test builds that I've been working on in my test creative world. And you can see, for the most part, it's just these kind of fence, like, gate design type of things. And then also, whatever these big structures are, you might be able to recognize it. But basically, what this was supposed to be, and then what this is actually, is a nice little church. But the reason I was testing some of these church and then fence designs is because of something I said in the end of our last episode, if you guys watched that. Basically, I said that I wanted to do something fun and funky for Halloween, although, yes, I know Halloween is already passed, but it's fine, it still counts because it's in the fall season, so I'm fine with it. But I want to build a pumpkin patch, and I figured it'd be a little bit boring if I just had, like, a normal pumpkin patch, you know, it's like, what am I gonna do with all those pumpkins, you know? So I figured I could make it sort of a spooky, haunted pumpkin patch. So I have this kind of spooky, darkish colors, fences to go around the whole thing. And that's the perimeter you guys saw me starting to build. I just have it all marked out with the blocks because, like, honestly, this is a little bit complicated of a build. It's really not. In essence, it's just a block, then, you know, two of these, what are they called? Two of these tile walls and then some gates. And that's pretty much it. A bunch of campfires, which is also why I needed that soul sand, because I'm going to be making these blue fire campfires because they look really nice. And then in the back, and I'll show you guys where I'm planning on building it, but I am planning on having this nice little church design, which I think it turned out really well. And don't worry, guys, before you say anything in the comments, it is not all going to stay cobblestone and like random bits of andesite. That's just so I can mark out, you know, where I'm actually going to be building it and the actual dimensions of it and stuff. What it's going to actually look like is it's going to be really disheveled and full of probably cracks and stuff. Like, I might have part of the roof caved in and stuff like that, because the theme is going to be, you know, spooky. So what's spookier than a church that may or may not be haunted, that's all like discombobulated and falling apart and stuff like that? That just fits the Halloween spooky vibes. So I'll probably do that. I'll have the fence going around, and then I might have some one or two other kind of spooky-ish builds, but these are the only things I actually planned out. But yeah, I mean, here you can see my original church design was just way too big and like clunky. It has like three block inset windows, and like this whole top area is just a just a mess. So I really tried to make it a lot smaller and kind of more refined for this tiny church. And then if you actually walk inside, I really like it. Like, it feels kind of cozy, but still it feels like cold. I guess that could just because of the cobblestone, but I feel like that's what a creepy church should feel like. It should feel like, I don't know, cold and atmospheric. And then obviously, you know, I mentioned it earlier, but we got the fences, which I think came out pretty good. I basically just wanted to have a nice thin but still moderately large fence design, so it did feel like you were kind of closed in, but also you could easily look past it and it wasn't too overbearing like some of these other designs were. These were my first mock-ups. Basically, I had this design for a gate, which I really ended up liking, and I pretty much used over there in the final design. But then some of the outside walls, they were like full blocks like this, and it was just way too big for the style that I wanted, especially in like resource count, because like these are full logs, and I do have that whole chest full of logs, but the majority of them are going to be going into these campfires, because the entire top of the fence is basically lined with campfires, which is going to be a lot of wood. But now that we're back in my regular Let's Play world here, I can go ahead and give you guys, I suppose, a mini tour of this area before we actually do start building anything. And luckily for you guys, you can see a nice little bird's eye view with the replay mod. But basically over here, there's already some naturally spawning pumpkins, which I thought was pretty cool. So I might just extend the pumpkin patch to be more so in this area. And then in the back here, or possibly like down there, I plan on doing some sort of wheat farm or something just to kind of fill in the space. Because honestly, it is a lot of space to play with. Like, you guys can see, we have the fence going all the way around here, and it basically stops over there when it hits the mountain. And same thing on the other side. It goes around this little hill over here, and then again, stops when you get to the mountain. We have this nice kind of inset thing here, and I was thinking maybe I could put in some sort of water, or have like a mini waterfall or something, but I'm not too sure about that. I'll probably think about that a bit more when I'm actually building, because above all else, I want this area to be spooky, and I'm not sure if a nice water feature with like bamboo and birds chirping would actually fit the spooky vibes I'm trying to go for. And then finally, we got up here, which is basically where I plan on making the church, and this used to be a lot more hilly than it was. I shaved down probably three or four blocks from this whole hill, basically, and then I had to plant a bunch of these giant trees to get the grass to be all this potsoil, I think it's called, which is taking a very long time. And then I kind of figured that if I'm going to be planting the trees anyway to make all the potsoil, I might just keep a few of these big trees here because they kind of look really cool. I'm thinking, like, if I fill in the rest of the area with a bunch of spruce trees, like normal spruce trees, then I could have a really nice kind of obscured view, and it might just look really cool and creepy. But yeah, the church will go up here, and then I'm also thinking probably next to the church, or maybe even down in that inset area, I'll put a nice graveyard, and I think that would also really just tie it all together and make it feel super spooky. Alright, so I've gathered a few materials that I need to actually start off this build here, and honestly, it makes me a little bit scared because I've used a lot of wood, and honestly, this is not a lot of stuff. That's not a lot of blocks, so I feel like I might need to pause the replay mod and go back and mine a bunch of blocks. But you know what? I guess it is what it is, because now we can actually go ahead and just go into the building process, and you guys thankfully get to see that nice and quick from the replay mod. But I gotta sit here for probably, I'm gonna guess an hour for just these outside walls, and we'll see what happens. But here we go, let's start. After a good night's sleep, of course. Freddy Fazbear always says to get enough sleep. And there we go, about an hour and a half later, so I was pretty close to my initial prediction, but we are, for the most part, done. Like, it's not quite done. As you can see, there's no campfires that are put around the top. Okay, can you, I did not realize I am taking so much damage, but I don't have the soul campfires put up here, and also some of the signs are missing just because I ran out of wood, and also it's a little bit annoying to place them for the replay mod, so I just figured I'd do that off camera sometime. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty much done. It looks honestly really good. I'll show you it from over there in a little bit, but for now there's a lot of mobs, so I'll just go on the inside here. But coming up here to where I'll eventually build the church, you guys can see it wraps all the way around. Honestly, I'm very happy with the design. It was a little bit cumbersome to make just because I had to use a lot of temporary blocks to place like the gaps in the corners and stuff like that, but I think it just works really well. And then again on the other side, you guys can already see, oh, some lightning there. It's getting spooky in here. But yeah, it looks really good. I'm very happy with it. But now that we have the outside wall slash fence, whatever you want to call it, done, I think what I'll do real quick is I will go ahead and add all the soul campfires up at the top just so we have a little bit of light, and hopefully a lot of these mobs stop spawning, although I also need to light up this inside area for sure. And then we can just go ahead and work on the church, which I think will also be pretty smooth sailing. The hardest part about the church build will just be texturing, because I do have a lot of cobblestone, but I don't have a lot of like andesite or stone or really anything else, so I'll probably have to go mining for some materials like that. But we can pretty much just start that build.
Whistling in the dark just to scare the ghosts away? I know there's something following me that I can't see. Someone sure laid an awful hex on me.
A hex? Aw, Tex, that's pretty far-fetched. Man, I think you're just a little bit touched.
If you'd have got a load of what I saw last night, you'd have passed a Yankee clipper on his maiden flight. Last night I saw up on the stair a little man who wasn't there. He wasn't there again today. I wish he'd go away. When I came home last night at 3, the man was waiting there for me. But when I looked around the hall, I couldn't see him there at all. Go away, go away, don't you come back anymore. Go away, go away, and please don't slam the door. Last night I saw up on the stair a little man who wasn't there. He wasn't there again today. Oh, how I wish he'd go away.
Yeah. Now that's what I call easy peasy lemon squeezy. And if I go all the way back here by my iron farm, you can see, oh my god, that looks so good. No, you can see if I'm walking up to it and it just renders in the distance, that looks amazing. That looks so good. And I actually do kind of like it with not having any trees around it. I'll probably put some trees like towards the back and stuff, but that looks so good. I am so happy with how that turned out. I mentioned earlier that I was going to try and do something where it kind of looks like disintegrated, I guess, like all broken down and run down and stuff. But I was thinking as I was building it, I kind of want the theme for this church to be like that. It's still somewhat in use. Like, obviously the interior is still like all nice and upkept. So I figured that it kind of wouldn't really make sense to have the exterior be all like broken down and there be holes in the roof and stuff. And also as I was building it, I realized that I just like didn't have a good design to make it even look run down or anything. So I just kind of did the normal stuff of like swapping a bunch of these blocks, like mossy cobblestone, mossy stairs, like andesite, gravel and stuff. So it still looks like it's sort of an older building, like it's kind of crumbling, but at the same time, it's still like, you know, it's still in use. And if you can go in here, you know, you can still, I guess, give like a sermon or whatever it's called. A guy can preach and people can sit down. So it's definitely an old building for sure, given the style, but at the same time, it's still like in use. And I think that made it look pretty good. But currently it's not a one-to-one replica of how it is in my creative world, because like I think up here is a little bit different. I have fence gates instead of just like fences, and then I think I did something different with these corners here, but I couldn't remember what I did, so I just kind of tried to make it look its best. But you know, there's still the area up here where I guess the, I don't know, rich people can come and talk. Traditionally in churches, this would be like where the organ or piano is, so someone could be playing it while the preacher preaches and like for the music and stuff. But I don't really know how to build a piano or an organ in Minecraft, so I just kind of have this as a stair area for, I guess, whatever rich people want to watch and have like a good a good view, I guess. Oh, and the last thing I wanted to mention is back here, there's a little door with kind of a secret button, and if you press that, you can go down here. And currently I have like nothing down here. It's kind of just like an empty little one by one with some stairs. But what I eventually planned this area to be is sort of like the cellar or like kind of underground storage area for this church. But currently I'm not gonna do that, just because, you know, I don't really have a design for that, and I'm just kind of like, this, the church is already built. So honestly, I'll just save that for some other time. Maybe I'll do that off camera, who knows. But the church itself is done, and now we can start working on the area around it. And I think what I'm gonna do right now is start trying to lay out this area, because I'm gonna have this area in front of it here be the grave, I guess, the cemetery. So I'll probably have some like dead trees and a bunch of dirt, stuff like that, to make it look like it's a grave. By the power of Freddy Fazbear, my inventory is miraculously filled with all the materials I need, and probably a lot more, to hopefully get this graveyard started. But before we actually get into building some of the gravestones, there's one thing I want to do first, and that is to give a little bit of a path to the door of this church here. And I'm not going to make the path very long. I'll probably just extend it to maybe like out to here, just kind of like in a very slight diagonal, just so I can get sort of a basis of where I actually want to build the grave, the cemetery, which is going to be like right in this area here. And I haven't built any of the rest of the path, so I don't want to go too crazy and make it too big, because I still do have a lot of work to do just in terraforming this area, which I'll probably have to get to off camera, just because, like, honestly, we're pretty close to this episode being over as is, so I don't want to do too much more work right now. I'll probably save it for either next episode or maybe something like off camera, something like that. But for now, I'm just breaking away some of the dirt here, and we're going to put in some gravel, and I'm probably going to mix this gravel with just some regular dirt blocks, and then also I can go ahead and make some of these into actual path blocks and just give a decent texture. Yeah, I think something like this looks pretty good, and I also didn't have any in my inventory right now, but I'll also probably add some like stone buttons and maybe even pressure plates around, just to make it look like rocks and stuff like that. And also I do plan on using some of this rooted dirt, just because it also provides a little bit of a different texture than the regular dirt texture, and I think it looks really good. However, I don't have a lot of this rooted dirt because it is so annoying and tedious to get. So I probably just got a few around for now, and then once I actually farm out some more, then I'll probably spread it around a lot more. I also just realized I could probably use some of these stairs and put them in the ground like this to try and give it even more of a textured look. You know what? Yeah, I think that does add a pretty considerable improvement. It does look a lot more weathered and textured, so I'm a fan of this. But now we can finally move on from the actual path and get to what I wanted to do, which is just build out the cemetery. So again, I'm gonna have it right here. I will probably eventually fence it in, but for now I'm just gonna leave it open. And I guess we're gonna start here probably in the back here, and I think in the back here, I was going to start with these anvils because they make a decent, like, gravestone head, but I think for the back, I'm going to start actually with some of this deep slate and just regular stairs and stuff like that and make these ones a little bit bigger than they normally would be. So I guess I'll do one right here is probably good. And this is going to be really nothing fancy. I'll probably just have some that look like this and then just a few different variations of this design. And then for the ground here, we're just going to dig out two of these blocks and put dirt here. And this dirt actually won't be overgrown by this because for some reason, it just like this doesn't grow like regular grass does. So this will stay dirt forever. And I think that looks decent. Again, I might replace some of them with rooted dirt just because that might look a little bit more weathered and good. Or maybe even I could do something with like gravel here, which that might actually look fine. But I'm pretty much just doing a bunch of variations of this. So we're going to build a few more and let's see how they look. And done. So there we go. It's looking pretty nice. It's a little bit hard to tell from where I'm standing because obviously it's just a flat ground. But yeah, okay. I'm liking it. So it looks a bit messy, but I did try and make it so you could still kind of tell where the actual, I guess, tomb would be, you know, because like it has a different material than the surrounding area. Is kind of the same thing I did with the path. But honestly, I'm really liking it. And there's one final thing I want to do before I eventually add like a fence and some probably more minor decorations, which I'll probably do off camera. And that is I want to add some custom kind of like dead trees. And I'm not really sure how exactly to do this because this is not something I usually ever do. I don't think I've ever even made any sort of tree in this style, dead or alive. But we're going to try my hand at making some custom trees and see how it goes. I mean, that looks fine. I'm just going to try and make it, like, decently rounded by adding a bunch of these slabs and, like, spruce trapdoors and stuff and even some fences like this. I can maybe put some, like, down here or, like, up like that, maybe. As you guys can tell, I really have no idea what I'm doing. But I think this is looking, like, fine so far. I probably need to add a little bit more to the top up there. I'm probably going to mess around with this design a little bit more. And I'll get back to you guys once I figure out what I'm doing. Okay, maybe something like this. Let's see how this looks. Take a step back. You know what? I think that's, it's kind of hard to give this thing a compliment. It's okay. It's definitely okay. I don't think it's anything great. I think it's just this one section right here because, like, the trunk area I do like. So maybe I just need to have this be more sort of connected, I guess. Try doing something like, that looks fine. That looks okay. We'll call this tree a work in progress, but I'm going to put a few of these dotted around the area here. Probably like maybe one somewhere in the center here, one like further back there, and maybe one more in the corner here. Maybe one right here. I don't know. Just a few trees. I'll put a few trees around and we'll see how it looks. And now that has been completed. And you know what? Not to toot my own horn, but I think some of these look really, really good. I mean, this one in particular, the last one I built, I think this one actually resembles a custom tree that like a good builder would probably make. Obviously, I don't really know what the style is, but I think I'm starting to get the hang of it with this. And I definitely want to practice it more because honestly, they didn't take too long to build and they were pretty fun, like doing organic shapes and stuff like that. It was kind of satisfying to build, honestly, but again, I probably do need to look at some references of actual like rotting, I guess, trees or just any sort of custom trees in Minecraft. But I am very happy with this little graveyard idea. I think it is nice, and I was gonna say cute, but I feel like describing a graveyard as cute is probably not the best word to describe it. But you know what, for what it's worth, I do think it's pretty cute. Or at the very least, I think it's pretty cool with like the pattern and depth, I guess, and detail that I tried to put in it. Although, to be honest, it kind of just looks like a jumbled mess of different blocks. Oh, and we got our first patron of the church here. Okay, coming to pray. I see you bringing your two friends here. Okay, I like it. I appreciate that. What do you got for me? Some packed ice, some nothing. I guess a Nautilus shell, but I don't really even have any emeralds to give this guy. But he's going back in for more. Oh, the church is such a, it's a rousing success. Look at that. You know what, it hurts me to say this, it really does, but I think unfortunately, guys, that is where I'm gonna have to end off this episode. And the reason it hurts so much to say that is because I know this episode is probably nearing the 20 minute mark, just because I had those two pretty long time lapses. I think for me, they were both like 50 minutes of footage that I have to edit down from the replay mod. And I think I already did the first one. It was around 6 minutes. So I imagine the second one of me actually building the church is also going to be somewhere around 6 minutes, which that already puts us at 12 minutes. And you know me, I'm a rambling guy. So I probably rambled on for at least 12 minutes, and that already puts us way past the time. So with that being said, this is the progress we are going to go ahead and leave off for this episode. But honestly, it's still a lot of progress. I mean, we did the entire outside wall to this spooky area. We made this whole upper area here pretty fancy with a custom graveyard cemetery area with a bunch of these dead trees, which I think turned out pretty nice. And obviously, we got the main attraction here, the church. I almost forgot the word church, but we got the church, which again, I think looks really, really good. I'm very happy with this build. I think it turned out great and spooky and really fits the vibes well. And lastly, if we go to the other side of this area here, and by the way, can I just say, I've only kind of realized this now, but this area is really big. Like, this is a giant building area. It is going to take me a little bit of time to actually fully clear and build everything in this area. And I think for the most part, I'm probably going to leave the middle part here as maybe just like a really densely populated area of trees or something. I'm not sure. But as I was saying, if we go over here, this is what I was preparing for the next step of this building process, which is basically this oval ring thing of cobblestone walls. And what is going to go inside of these cobblestone walls is going to be where we put our pumpkin patch. So you see, it's a pretty big area, and that's because I want to have a really nice pumpkin patch with a lot of kind of different levels of elevation. You can see here it has the gradual slope down with also some bits that kind of stick out here. Actually, this whole thing right here, this used to be caved in and be kind of like a swoop like this. I pretty much just inversed that and put a bunch of dirt on top of it, and also unfortunately I had to build over all of this dirt into the regular grass dirt, so I'm gonna need to plant more of these big trees to convert this area also into the grass that I want it to be. But that will all come in time. I might even do that off camera because that process is so long and time consuming and super boring to watch. But that is the plan for, I suppose, next episode of this playthrough, where we will continue our little spooky pumpkin patch area and hopefully finish it that episode and just, you know, kind of conclude the spooky season, spooky vibes within my Let's Play world. But before I forget, there was actually two things I really wanted to show you real quick, and the first thing is actually going to be over here. Right in here, right outside of my gate here, I found this hole, and I thought this hole was pretty cool because it's like a perfect 3x3 square, and then it obviously goes down into like a cave or whatever, but I thought that was really cool because it's just like, I don't know, it's perfect. But the reason I brought that up at all is because if we go back over here, okay, never mind, it looks like two creepers are guarding it, and also I'm getting bombarded from behind, so let me go sleep real quick. If we go back over here, you can kind of see it from where I'm standing right here, but it's sort of just this, you know, nice little hill area here with a little inset. But if you look in here, there's one of these, and I don't know if you guys watching are old enough to remember this, but back when Minecraft was super, super new, basically when Minecraft was back in its beta, Herobrine was a thing, and Herobrine used to come in your world and leave these little kind of 2x2 holes just randomly in your world. Obviously, Herobrine isn't real, and he didn't actually do that. It was just a bug with, like, world generation. But I thought this was so cool because this is a naturally spawning thing, and the way it shaped makes me think that it was probably just a ravine that maybe got cut off by, like, the mountain here. But I thought that was so, so cool because I didn't, like, mine into this. This just happened naturally, and I feel like if I mine lower down here, there's probably going to be like a ravine or something, because there is a ravine that's like just over there too. But I think I'm going to keep this because this is super cool. And gamers, who knows? Ooh, maybe Herobrine's in my world. Oh, but no, obviously not. Unless. But gamers, with that being said, that is going to be the end of this episode here. So I very much hope you guys all enjoyed. I know that this episode was very spooky vibes, and you know, possibly you guys aren't in the spooky season vibes anymore because, I mean, let's be honest, it's like 2 weeks past Halloween at this point, and for that, I do apologize for getting this episode out so drastically late. But listen, I still love the spooky vibes, so I figured I might as well still go ahead and do it because it's just very fun, and also I like doing themed builds because I think they're also very fun and cool, and hopefully you guys will enjoy watching it. So, gamers, with that being said, that's going to be all for today's video. Like the video if you like it, subscribe if you liked it. Thanks for watching, and be sure to stick around for next week's episode. I don't know if it's actually going to be next week's episode or just the next episode, but stick around for the next episode where we continue this haunted pumpkin patch area and hopefully finish it, and it should be a lot of fun. So again, guys, do all that stuff. Like, subscribe, favorite, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.